I think another reason why I brought that up, because maybe the Bucks, I could see Bezos having that conversation about the Bucks being like more serious, because hopefully next year they'll be better. But the combination of Joel Embiid, and then I heard the Paul George comments. I don't know if y'all heard the Paul George comments. If I was never really like a huge Paul George guy, based off of this clip, I am totally out on Paul George. This, like him explaining his contract situation.
What was the negotiations like with the Clippers to let you know that, hey, I'm leaving y'all and I'm going to Philly?
Just to put it out there, like, I never wanted to leave LA. LA is home. This is where I wanted to finish at. I wanted to work as hard as possible to win one in LA. Like, that was the goal, to be here and be committed to LA. As it played out, though, like, the first initial deal was, I thought, kind of disrespectful, right? And again, no, in all of this, no hard feelings. So the first initial deal was like 2 years, 60. So I'm like, whoa.
Hey, that's crazy, bro.
That's crazy. That's right.
That's
Crazy.
crazy.
That's crazy.
So I'm like,
What?
no, I'm not signing that. This was maybe like October-ish. Negotiations first started, and it was 260. And as we kept going, it was like, they would go up, inches, 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 to where it was like 44, 45, right? But this was like a couple months in between before we got it to 40 something. I'm still like, nah, I'm not doing that. Then I hear wind of like, what they're going to give Kawhi. So I'm like, just give me what Kawhi got. Like,
right.
Y'all view us the same. Like, we came here together. We want to finish this together. I'll take what Kawhi got. Like,
He was
no
cool with
problem.
that.
I was cool with that. Like,
Wow.
and we were still taking less. We were taking less. Kawhi took less. I was like, if Y gonna take less, I'm not gonna say I want more than Y. Like,
Big Y.
I'm not like, it's not about me being paid more than him. Like, I'm gonna take what he got. Y'all
Right,
give him that,
right.
give me that. They didn't want to do that. So this was before the All-Star break. So I'm like, you know what? I don't want, like, don't even, let's not even have no more conversation. Like, let's just play this year out. 'Cause it was starting to get into like my mood. Now I'm, you know what I mean? Like,
Quarters.
I didn't want to have that energy carry over into the team. Season in, I finished healthy, 74 games played, and had one of my most efficient seasons. So now we go into negotiations. Now they bring it to 3 years,
Where we at?
150. All right. That's cool. It sucks that it had to get to this point, like that we couldn't get this figured out a lot sooner. But now we at the end of the year, 3 years, 150. So I'm like, all right, like now we're in a ballpark. You know what I mean? Now we can have conversation here. I presented the 3 150, no trade. 'Cause in the meeting they're like, we want you here long term. We wanna, when you're retired, we want you to be a Clippers for a lifetime, like all of this stuff. So I'm like, cool. Give me the 3 years, 150, no trade then. Like, no trade clause. Then I'm not, like, I'm taking less, but at least I know I'm here. Like, I'm committed to y'all. Like, they didn't want to
They
do the
didn't
no
want to
trade.
do that.
Wow.
So then now
What?
I'm like, all right, well, then it only makes sense for me to do 4 years, 212, right? Like, at least pay me my money. If y'all gonna trade me, then y'all gonna trade me. But at least, like, now I'm not in a situation where I could have got more had I just gone to free agency. Then take this deal, and y'all could just ship me wherever I want. And now I'm on this deal that I didn't want. So they didn't want to do that. So now I was like, now I'm open to entertaining what's out there. And then, I mean, through the negotiations, they wasn't budging. They weren't gonna budge. I wasn't gonna budge. I thought I played well enough for them to, be like, you know what? He's a part of our future. Like, I thought I
Ooh,
did
50
that. I thought I earned
million.
that. Granted, we didn't win while I was there, but luck has a lot to do with that. We couldn't remain healthy as a unit. But I thought I did enough to earn that. I love Steve, I love Lawrence, but at that point it didn't even feel right to come back with that type of energy and be comfortable playing back in LA.
It was a lot of genjutsu right there. I know people are looking down trying to do the math.
All right, dude. Yeah,
I'm sorry. I was trying to figure out what he got. My bad.
Yeah, no, I already did the math if you called me looking.
I just got it. I got it written down just to just a little bit more. First deal was 2 for $60 is what they offered him. 2 years, $60 million.
Yep.
$30 million a year. They kind of got up to $45 million a year. Then he asked for the Kawhi deal because him and Kawhi were the same. Him and Y were the same. I'll take the Kawhi deal afterwards. Still said no. Then they get up to $3,150, which is $50 million a year. And then he throws in a no trade clause for some reason. I can't, and then they say no. And so then he gets up to $4,212, which is $53 million a year. And they said no. Now, remember, he said he would have taken the Kawhi deal, but now we're at $4,212.
What was the Kawhi deal?
Yeah, I don't want to misremember it, but I want to say that the Kawhi deal was the $3,150, right?
Now let me tell you something. It wasn't the $4,212. It was $3,150.
Yeah, that was Kawhi. Okay.
Damn. He was eligible for a 4-year extension for $223. He took the $3,150. He said him and Kawhi were valued the same, but somehow Paul George got up to $4,212.
I'm gonna be. I guess I'm turning heel. Hot take. I don't got a problem with it. I ain't gonna lie. Look, bro, dead ass. When I think of the Los Angeles Clippers and why they have failed, been two things. One, playoff P, LOL. But more importantly, too, Kawhi's not there. Kawhi, we've made this joke several times on many pods that Kawhi Leonard is all but a Woj tweet away from being gone. So where I'm going with this is essentially Paul George has kind of gotten like the raw shaft of this whole fucking ordeal in the Clippers stratosphere or whatever this entire time. So yes, he is being greedy. I think, my God, especially with me and Omar debating fucking Snowfall, greedy is the word of the fucking day. But no cap, no trade clause if he's going to take, I believe, $9 million less for the 3 years versus, because the 4 years, I think that's the increase is $3 million a year. I want to say so. But if he's going to take $9 million less dollars, I can understand why he wants a no trade clause in the situation of, all right, this shit ain't going to work. Kawhi keeps getting hurt. Fuck it. We're going to take the best suitor. And then he doesn't want to be dealt somewhere. I understand where he's coming from. Now, do I think that it's selfish? Yet again, yes. But I actually don't necessarily have the animosity towards Paul George here, like how 90% of the world is going to. Because when you really think about it from his point of view, he kind of got cooked for 4 years. I'm not going to lie.
I already was on the anti-Paul George train. I was already saying fuck Paul George when he went on his little podcast and he decided to dance around the fact that he blamed James Harden for coming over for why shit fell apart. I was already saying that was an excuse. That was a cop-out. L cop out. I said that then. This has done nothing but added fuel to the fire of fuck Paul George. I am out, in the famous words of my OG Chilltown. I'm out. I'm out on this dude. I can't do it. This is hands down. I get it. Listen, before anything, I understand professional athletes. Hey, man. Chase the money on. Get all the dollars while you can get all the dollars. I get it. Don't leave money on the table. Take all your bread. I understand it. I get it. I agree. Don't sit there and say, I want to do what's best for the team. Don't play the role of, yeah, oh, me and this guy are the same. I view us as the same. Don't lie to me. I hate liars. One, Paul George, you know damn well when you lay your head to rest at night, you know who the number one is. Y'all niggas know who the best player on the team is. That is why. Big why. The nigga you call why. I know he don't call you G. That nigga just called you Paul. You want to know why? Because he's the number one.
Paul he's George the best said that player.
We all know this.
Yeah.
So I don't care if they lied to you and said, oh, we view y'all as the same. Nigga, you know y'all not the same. And the fact that you went out your way to get essentially, well, get less, what they offered you less than what they gave James Harden. Cool. Don't take the 2 for 30, the 2 for 60. I give you that. Damn that one. Whatever. Once you got to where Kawhi was, oh, give me what Kawhi got. Now you want to throw extra shit in? Does Kawhi have a no trade clause?
No,
I don't think so.
It's only LeBron, Luke Kornet, and somebody else. But yeah, it's only LeBron. And
Mike
Luke
Conley, Kornet. I think. Mike Conley.
So, yeah, I think it's Mike Conley.
Yeah.
So that if they good. View y'all, if right. they view y'all as the same, and they gave you the same deal, and you say no, and you ask for a no trade clause, which Kawhi doesn't have, and they say no, and your counter to that is, shit, I want more than Kawhi. You view you over Kawhi, nigga? You? Of all people? You? Nah, buddy. I'm sorry. I don't care how competitive you are. You ain't no goddamn Kawhi Leonard, my nigga. Like, stop it. You know who you are. That's why you hightailing it to the East Coast to play your real role. Super Tobias. That's what you want to be.
Jesus Christ.
You know what you want to be, and that's why you're going to be that. Super Tobias, my G. That's what you want to be.
No, and I'm not gonna go as aggressive as Damo per se, but ultimately, the idea he's covering himself, which I get. If they did offer 2 for 60, which I you know he doesn't necessarily need to lie right there, that is low. Now, when that 2 for 60 was in play, is a conversation. Because if everybody was going to take 2 for 60, that should have been, you know, more of the angle if they had plans with the 2 for 60, you know, whatever the case may be. Whatever the conversation about 2 for 60, there, I think that there's some context missing. But even then, it seems like there was going to be some more conversation. I think that there's another missing piece added to this, but because of the organization, no piece of it, we probably won't ever hear it. Like, I think that Paul George is truly missing some context, whether he has it or not. I think that there is another side of this in the fact that, you know, the Clippers may have been working for something. Why they would offer Kawhi Leonard that, and then why they would offer you that without anything else going on. I hope he doesn't take it in, like, some sort of wrong way. I could understand the frustration of lacking security, but ultimately, I think they talked to y'all a minute ago. Y'all were going to be the LA guys. Hell, they took pictures of y'all in the new jerseys. Like, they were bought in on y'all. They took pictures of y'all in the new jerseys and had your new jerseys printed and ready to be shipped when they launched the whole new branding. Paul George, I think that they were bought into y'all. I don't know. I really can't get behind this idea that you were questioning security. And then, like Damo said, the whole Kawhi Leonard same value. You know, and then when presented with that, you decide to add stuff. At that point, that's you, gang. I don't know.
Yesterday's price ain't today's price, apparently. So
But again, don't say now after the fact. Oh,
yeah.
I mean, never mind. Let me not say that because he was speaking in the past tense when he said they viewed us as the same. And at that time, now don't make it seem like at the time it was about. Oh, you view us the same. You view me and Kawhi the same. Because when they gave you the same money, you asked for more at that time. You're not even speaking in past tense about if feelings change or anything. You're saying at that time, they viewed y'all as the same. Bet I'm not going to take more than Kawhi. That's what he said. And unless I misheard things, he didn't allude to the fact that, oh, because my mood changed, now I want more. Now things change now. Or now because I'm in this mood, things change. Yesterday's price ain't today's price. I don't think he alluded to that.
He didn't say like the market changed or the need was there or I talked to Joel, whatever the case, which of course he can't say he talked to Joel. But he didn't allude to anything that would make me think that he got wind. Now, in the contrast, the Jalen Brunson situation from what, last year or 2 years ago, whatever the case may be, mm-hmm. Jalen Brunson literally says, hey, it was like this, it was like this, it was like this. They weren't having a conversation. We never came to a deal. I put it off to the end of the season. And then I went stupid in the playoffs. As far as I understand, when they went to around the All-Star break, the Clippers went into a slump. And a lot of Clippers Nation is saying he had a pity party during that time. I don't want to put that on him because I don't have the numbers right, but that's what they're saying. So mm-hmm. I don't know. I can't agree with you. I know you said that, B-Souls, but I can't agree that the whole yesterday's price.
My fault, and I just want to add, he did say we end the season and I have a healthy year and I'm more efficient. So maybe if that's his justification for now adding no trade clause, or now things might be a little different because, again, he had a healthy year where he played 74 games, and he's, in his words, most efficient season he's had, or better years of efficiency he's had. So didn't want to put that tidbit out there. Go ahead, Sage.
I just think this whole conversation, if I'm remembering directly what happened, and that it's 3 years, 150, that's essentially the offer that Y got. Don't know why he's calling him Y, fair enough.
That's homie.
But if Big Y, never the little one, had 3 150, and the Clippers did offer that to Paul George, the idea that Paul George basically wanted a little bit more than that, again, maybe this is a hot take, or I froze earlier, so maybe this is the hot take. I don't see a problem with Paul George wanting a bit more than that, considering that Kawhi was never fucking there when it mattered most. I understand Kawhi is definitely better than Paul George when healthy. I understand that Paul George would defer to Kawhi if they're both healthy. But unfortunately, and sorry my phone went off there, unfortunately, Kawhi's never there. He's just never there. In the regular season, he plays. I think this season, they – like in the same ballpark, unless I'm mistaken, I don't have the numbers in front of me, but every postseason for like literally to a memeable level for the last 3 years, I want to say, random old tweet, Kawhi's out. So I'm not necessarily viewing Paul George in a villainous way in terms of wanting more than Kawhi. However, what I do think is bullshit, and I'll agree with everybody on this stage, or at least Damo and Omar here, the loyalty thing. Where do you see that from outside of 2 years, 2 years, 60? And if that's something that you didn't forget and forgive, cool. But outside of that, where did you see the Clippers may not be loyal to me? I need a no trade clause at any point in time in the Clippers tenure. They did treat you, at least while you were brought in, at least while you were the guy that was healthy, they did treat you like a level on the Kawhi Leonard. So I don't think that you needed that in writing necessarily. That's kind of like a weird angle to go at, but still wanting a no trade clause and still wanting a equal level to Kawhi Leonard's contract, or even perhaps a $3 million annual more. I don't see a major issue with it because he kind of got screwed over throughout the entirety of this run because the guy that's supposed to be with him was not there when they needed him most, literally for 3 years straight. I don't see how we have this anti-agenda. The only thing I give y'all is that, yeah, he definitely doesn't want to be a number one.